Alright, so here's the deal. 12 alien spaceships have landed at various locations across the world, and they're just sitting there. Are they friendly? Are they testing us, evaluating us? Are they the vanguard of an invasion? What's going on? Unfortunately, we can't talk to them, and that is the crux of this film. If you go into this film expecting Independence Day, you are going to be in for a really, really bad time, because there's not really any action in this film. This is a more cerebral, more realistic take on what First Contact is actually going to be like. We can't speak their language, they can't speak our language, and the pressure is mounting. Despite the fact that this film is basically set on a soundstage and in a field, you feel the vastness of the world as the different countries struggle to come to terms with the fact that aliens exist, they have parked themselves in seemingly random locations, and we don't know what their intentions are. Amy Adams puts in an absolutely amazing performance as the lead character, a woman struggling with the loss of a daughter who's trying desperately to solve what these aliens are doing here. She is aided and assisted by Jeremy Renner, who's also struggling. He can't seem to stay in focus half the time, and for some reason he's based his character on Dr. Ian Malcolm from Jurassic Park. And as much as I love Ian Malcolm from Jurassic Park, he does tend to get a little bit grating at times. She's backed up by an amazing cast, including Forrest Whitaker as a general who's just trying to make the best of a bad situation. And you'd think that First Contact would be enough, but the world has different nations. There is no one central leader, so every country risks starting an interstellar war purely by being stupid. And I love that they went into all the technical details, making sure that every scientific aspect is perfectly realistic. I even like that they went into the fact that the United Nations would pretty much be ignored by every nation state. I understand why some people might not like this film. Yes, it's a First Contact film, but it's a lot more like Contact than it is Independence Day. It's a slow, cerebral film, and I perfectly understand why some people walked out of my screening, but myself, I absolutely loved it. This is an amazing film. It's a little slow, but aside from that, there's absolutely nothing wrong with it. This is a see-it-now film. Drop what you're doing. Get rid of all ideas of whiz-bang explosions. Arrival is one of the best films of the year. Don't be surprised when it turns up in my top 10 in a few weeks. But what did you guys think? Have you seen it? And what do you think is the best First Contact film? Comment below, let me know. I'm Daniel, this has been a Dunking. If you've enjoyed this video, please like, share, and subscribe.